Thank you, Dr. Hiranandani. And ladies and gentlemen, it's now time for us to give the loudest cheer as we welcome on stage and on the mic the Honorable Secretary, Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs, Government of India. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Shri Durga Shankar Mishra ji. Thank you, sir.
Good afternoon, Mr. Niranjan Hiranandani, President of NAREDCO, and the various executives and Peter on the dais, all the representatives of NAREDCO representing different sectors of stakeholders in the real estate business, participating in the 2 days workshop here. First, let me thank you for inviting me to be part of your deliberations here. You had invited me to come here yesterday to witness Mr. Hiranandani taking over as the president of NAREDCO, but somehow because of some commitments, I couldn't come yesterday, but I assured them that definitely I will be here. And I spent some time with the whole workshop. But at the same time, I am going to sit with some of the representatives and try to hear from them, listen to them, what is that which we can do from the government side to give boost to this business of the real estate. Well, the country is going through a transformative change. For the last 3 years, you must be hearing our Honorable Prime Minister and the governments at different forums, the vision of the government. Now the latest in that is the Vision 2022. The Prime Minister had sown the seed of the New India, New India 2022, when we are going to celebrate the 75th anniversary of the Indian independence, the new India should be born. A new India where there is no corruption. A new India where there is no poverty. A new India where there is no communalism, casteism, terrorism, etc., etc. A new India which fulfills the hopes and dreams of every citizen of India. And how can that be possible without having a shelter for himself or herself? There it combines with the vision of housing for all by 2022, when we are going to celebrate the 75th anniversary of Indian independence. There should be all-weather house with all the facilities like toilets and everything to every Indian citizen. That is what the country has resolved to provide in the next 5 years. That's a big resolve. But that is possible. It is not a dream, it's a reality which is possible, which can be done. And it can be done not only by the government, but it has to be done by the government. The people like you who are the very, very important stakeholders in the business of the real estate. The banks who are here, we have the National Housing Bank Chairman, CMD is right here. And various other banks, I met with the madam, she is former HDFC. So this is various stakeholders in this business and the individual beneficiaries themselves. Because they must also think, unless or until the person who is living in the slums, he thinks that he has to change his life. He has to give a different way of life, different quality of life to his family, things will not change. So it has to be everybody, whosoever is involved in this, they need to participate. Well, the task is big. When this was estimated in 2012, by a technical committee of planning commission, the then planning commission, which has now changed into Niti Aayog. The task was nearly 1.8 crore houses, shortest in that study. And majority of them in the economically weaker section and the lower income group. Precisely 54% and 42%, that accounts for nearly 96%. Just 4% in other sectors, like MIG and HIG, etc., etc. There is a dichotomy. We have plenty of houses, Mr. Hiranandani just mentioned. That some 200,000 houses are lying vacant, just at the tip of being completed in the National Capital Region. Yet, we have plenty of people who are living in slums in the same National Capital Region who do not have houses, who are living in the sub-standard housing conditions. This gap needs to be filled up. And that is why when the Prime Minister, Honorable Prime Minister Sri Narendra Modi ji, when he announced that by 2022 we have to provide all weather shelter to everybody, we in the government have been trying to get that mission, get that dream fulfilled, which is not the dream of only Honorable Prime Minister, it's a dream of the country. We as a nation can celebrate when we have this new India, that everybody has a shelter, to create an ecosystem through which this could be made possible. And that is how this Prime Minister's Awas Yojana Urban was conceived and launched by the Honorable Prime Minister in June 2015. In the last 2 years, it's only 2 years and few months, we have been able to sanction more than 26 lakhs houses so far. We have been able to ground more than 9 lakhs houses. We have been able to complete more than 3.5 lakhs houses and deliver it to the individual beneficiaries. It's a tremendous work. I mean, compared to what was done earlier, it's a very fast pace with which things are moving. Yet the task is very big. How to do that? Our Honorable Minister was here yesterday. He told you about the public-private partnership. We have tried to create a model of public-private partnership. 6 models where the public land used as a resource. 2 models where the private land is there and we create an ecosystem in which things can be moved very fast. Since the Minister has already narrated all different those things, and it is already available on our website. Yesterday, after the Honorable Minister's announcement, I have sent it to all the Chief Secretaries. And we'll discuss in our next meeting with the State Principal Secretaries and Secretaries. When you are going to discuss with our Mission Directors, we'll discuss what to do, how to do, how to create that ecosystem where the private sector can come in a big way, participate with their strength. They have finance, they have efficiency, they have skills, they have expertise. How can that be leveraged to deliver this housing? Only yesterday I was sitting with ILFS. This was my second meeting in ILFS in the last 2.5 months. And yesterday meeting, Mr. Harishankar, he committed to me that they are going to get 10 lakhs houses. Yes, ILFS is going to get 10 lakhs houses, costing 12 lakhs or less in the affordable section. That is the spirit of with which I would like. Mr. Hiranandani said that we'll make 5 lakhs houses in Mumbai. Yes, we will try to create that ecosystem, we'll try to create that salt pan. If it is possible, we'll create that system, make everything possible so that these 5 lakhs houses, affordable houses, can come in Mumbai, in all big cities. Most of the cities have large chunk of population living in the slums. And one of the important verticals under our Prime Minister Awas Yojana Urban is in situ slum redevelopment, where it is not only we are going to help the slum redevelopment through permission of additional FSI, getting the approvals done very fast, but also government is giving 1 lakh rupees per house. This will ensure that the slums can be converted into beautiful places. And the slums, along with other kinds of housing, the higher kind of, maybe MIG, maybe HIG kind of housing, which will cross-subsidize this, that will be made possible. It is a part of our Prime Minister Awas Yojana. We have affordable housing under partnership. We are looking forward to the private sector to come in a big way. Once we have given this model, please participate. It is possible. You can, any of the models we can use, and you can come up with houses which are affordable. Houses which are affordable, where the people who do not have, our beneficiaries are such, who do not have house anywhere in the country, which do not have a pakka house, an all-weather house. If such people are given these houses, you automatically qualify for getting 1.5 lakhs houses per house, per individuals. We are pushing for credit link subsidy scheme, where we are providing subsidy to the tune of almost 2.5 lakhs per house, and it is upfront subsidy. When a bank has sanctioned house, affordable house, to an individual, if he is from the EWS category or LIG category, up to the loan of 6 lakhs, he is getting subsidy to the tune of 6.5% repayment period of 20 years, which amounts to nearly 2.5 lakhs. For MIG, for loan up to 9 lakhs, when it is 90 square meter, loan up to 12 lakhs, when it is 110 square meter, we are providing the subsidy. And this subsidy goes upfront. That way the EMI is reduced automatically. That can be used in a big way by the private sector. You have, if these houses are ready, we can have the banks, the private developer, and the beneficiary, we can, all three can sit together. We can create an environment in which all three of them can sit together. And the beneficiary automatically gets this money, his EMI is reduced. In fact, this MIG scheme, which Honorable Prime Minister announced on 31st December 2016, was only for 1 year. We have just decided in the government that this scheme will continue up to 2019 March, so another 1 year. Because now it has started picking up. We have just spent some 270 crores under the MIG. Now we think here is a high time when this will move in a positive direction. But our focus is more on affordable housing. Our focus is on LIG and the economically weaker section. So there is a lot of scope where the private sector can participate. We are working for this, our scheme of Prime Minister Awas Yojana. This is limited only in the city limits. That is the corporation limit. We want to extend that to the area which has been notified as a development area. That is the development authority, maybe industrial development authority, maybe special area development authority. All that area where there is a master plan, there is a zonal plan, there is a layout plan approved by a particular authority, which is a kind of a planned development, we would like that area also to be covered in affordable housing, so that, because mostly the developments are coming in such areas, we are working on it, and very soon we are going to make amendment to our policy. We are also working on providing proper ecosystem to the beneficiaries. They get a loan. We very soon, I mean, we have already started tying up with the banks. How we can, they can have the loan. They can have the comfort of, because the person may not be able to come forth with a, I mean, he doesn't have the wherewithal to spend, say, 3-4 lakhs, even after giving 1.5 lakhs from the central government, another 1 lakhs or so from the state government, maybe another 4 lakhs. How can he get that? We are working on that so that the banks provide that, we create an environment in which the individual gets a loan and it gets a very easy EMIs so that he is able to afford it and he is able to get his house. We are also working on the PSU's land, the government lands. How can these PSU lands can be leveraged? We can use the private sector that can be leveraged for creating affordable housing in a big way. So in brief, we are just trying to create different kinds of systems through which affordable housing, which where there is a large need, is a large gap, that gap can be filled in. And there, your role is very, very important. You mentioned that, I mean, normal apprehension is things do not move in the government. We have tried to create a system of, in fact, that's another vision of Honorable Prime Minister, to create ease of doing business. You must be hearing this, that in the different kinds of sectors, different sectors, right from registration up to liquidation, every part of the business is being taken care of by the different segments of the government to create ease in doing business. As far as we are concerned with the construction sector, that is ease of doing business in construction permits. And in Delhi and Mumbai, we have been able to, in Delhi and Mumbai, we have been able to create a system, online system, and also a lot of changes. I mean, those who are here from Mumbai or Delhi, they may be aware. In fact, almost on a weekly basis, I used to review these things and see that the whole building bylaws, the development control norms get changed. The way they were doing the business, that whole thing gets changed. And the person gets his permission, gets his building permission, and also his completion certificate, also the inspection thing, in a time-bound manner. I'm very happy to tell you that the average time in Delhi has come down to as low as 7 to 8 days. I mean, there are cases which takes around 30 days. But there are cases which take even less than 1 day. In Mumbai, it is around 17 to 18 days. We are working on it so that there is a completely seamless integration of all kinds of NOCs. Yes, we mentioned about CRZ. Some of the things have not been made possible, but we are working on it. It's a continuous improvement so that the person who comes for the building permission, he only has to apply at one place and doesn't have to go from door to door to get his clearances done. It is automatically through the system. It's a seamless integration with different system. All NOCs are clear and he gets his permission well in time. We are working on making the same thing possible in all million plus cities, all 53 cities. Two of them, Delhi and Mumbai, has been cleared. The balance 51 to be done before 31st of March 2019. And we'll do that. I have a full confidence that we'll be able to do that. That every city, you go to the city of Banaras, go to the city of Kanpur, or go to the city of Nagpur, everywhere we'll do that. We'll make this ease of doing business in construction in such a way that people have a hassle-free and a good experience in getting permits done, where they were taking years. In fact, one of the important changes in this has been the environment clearance, which used to take years. It was a really horrifying experience. But now, that power up to 1,50,000 square meter build-up area has been delegated to the local body. They don't have to take it to the committee or somewhere. It's a local body, and there they have to examine it and see that clearances are given just within a month. What I mean to say that we are just trying to create an ecosystem through which we allow this business to prosper, because we understand how important it is. Every 1 lakh rupees spent on the this sector creates nearly 2.5 jobs. And if you take the effect of indirect impact on things like cement industry, furniture industry, steel industry, all materials, bricks, etc., the total works comes out to nearly 4 jobs per lakh spent in the sector. That's a huge gain. So we are here to give a push. We are also working on the technology. This whole Prime Minister Awas Yojana, there is a technology mission. One of the sub-mission is a technology mission, where we have tried to create various kinds of technological options where things could be done in a faster manner, using new ways of doing things. In fact, I'm happy to announce you that so far, 5 of these technological methods, our CPWD, which is the technical arm of the central government for all kinds of public work, they have already notified SOR in 5 major technologies in the alternative technologies which are available for construction works, so that estimates could be prepared and approval could be done right away. We have also given guidelines to the state that when they are coming with affordable housing, big housing projects, it should become technology neutral. How you are going to do it, it is not important. What you are going to do it, that is more important. It has to be made affordable. So using the best of the technologies, you have to do it in such a way that you can bring down the cost. And let me tell you, today nearly 2.6 lakhs houses across the country, they are being constructed using different kinds of the new technologies. Very recently in Ranchi, some 40,000 houses are coming. They have gone for international bidding, and there they have, it's a completely technology neutral. Any kind of technology can come, and they have an issue that they have to create this 40,000 housing, and these 40,000 housing is to be created in a particular time frame. They have to bring down the cost, and they are the tender is on. Our Honorable Prime Minister has gone beyond it. Around 1.5 months back, he gave me a direction in a meeting that why can't we get the best technologies across the world, which is available in any part of the world, in our country, and let those technologies live in this country for the future. Because today, it is possible that you can do the construction. Thousands of houses can be constructed in few months, 4 months, 5 months, 6 months. Such technologies are available, and such technologies are being used in a big way. We have taken upon this Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs, we have taken upon us the direction of Honorable Prime Minister, and we are working towards that construction challenge. We'll have a construction challenge. Some of you, the NAREDCO was very much part of my round table, which was held around 2 weeks back. We are trying to create a construction challenge where we'll have large number of housing, 200 to 500 houses in different parts of the country. And we'll have a global participation. We'll have a local partner and some international partner who is coming with the technology, local partner coming with the capacity. And both of them together will create these housing, will create a system what your president just mentioned. We'll give a place, we'll give a complete building plan, the finances, everything will be given. Now the challenge will be how fast and how less costly you can create a house which will adhere to all kinds of our requirement under the Russell Building Code, which adheres to the green building requirements, so that in the long run there is a least usage of the resources, least cost. So this is, we are trying to create a system, and it will be open. I mean, this is not going to be a closed system, it will be open system where anybody and everybody in the country can come and learn the technology and take the technology forward. In fact, those who are going to participate, they will get, I mean, if you can prove this in this country, you can prove it anywhere in the world. You have so much of business. When we have this large number of housing coming up, you have so much of business right here. Lot of people have shown interest. Lot of people have shown interest after we have announced, and almost every week we are moving forward. We are, I mean, working on it. We are coming with a system in which this construction challenge will be possible. Only two days back, we had a presentation with a Dubai-based company, KEF, who have their plant in Hosur in Karnataka near Bangalore. They are doing in a big way, but again, that big way is a small one. We want the country to feel that ripple. We want the country to get that technology embedded into our system or academic system or practice by the government, practice by the private sector, by the developers. Everybody using such technologies for mass creation. Because our country is big, our requirements are big, and all that which we are going to do is going to spin off our whole economy. The economy which is growing at almost 7%, there was a little dip. Again, the finance minister expressed that it is going to be back on the track, over 7% growth very soon, and that can leapfrog to 10%. I mean, it can go to two digit if this sector grows very fast. We are here, I mean, let me assure you, under the leadership of our Honorable Prime Minister, his vision is to make a new India. And the new India is, we can stand next to any of the best of places, we say, aha. Go to Singapore, you have get a feeling. Go to Kuala Lumpur, you get a feeling. You should have the same feeling here in Mumbai, you should have the same feeling in Delhi or Bangalore or any place within our country. It is our own people who are doing it. When, in fact, 2 days back, when this Dubai company was making presentation, other than 1%, all others were Indians. They had come from Dubai, but they were all Indians. So we are doing it in Dubai, why can't we do it on our home? We don't have less capabilities. It is just a question of little bit tweaking on our system, having faith and trust on ourselves, having confidence on ourselves that we can do it, and I'm sure we can do it. So I think there is a plenty of things, big challenges. Experience might have been good, bad, mix, anything. But when you start working for a mission, when you start working for a challenge, you forget about what you had, you keep looking forward to. And that looking forward to is the big challenge of creating that affordable housing at affordable cost, take such measures which will cut down the cost and improve the experience for those who matter a lot for this economy. They all contribute. If you provide them proper housing, they will contribute far, far better, and that will be further additional impact to our economy. So, in brief, we are here to create that system. We are working for the smart city, we are working for the urban infrastructure, we are working for Swachh Bharat, and all that is interlinked to this sector. That's the grand vision of the new urban India. New urban India is a new India 2022. So with these words, I hope that your deliberations are going to be very, very useful. You mentioned about the rental housing. Yes, we are also working on the rental housing. It's very, very important sector. I'll expect an input from you. If you give us input, it will help us in further crystallizing our thoughts on this rental housing. What is that which will make? I mean, there things are working very well in maybe Europe, but India is India, and we have to create a system which will work in India. So we will expect an input from you after the deliberations, and we'll take that seriously. We'll have more closed door discussion like one I'm going to have right now. We'll have more of such discussions, and I'm sure together we'll be able to do a lot to contribute towards improving our economy and giving better experience and better housing to our own people. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very, very much.